Everyone, welcome back to the Comic Book ASM Artist. Today we're going to be doing a video of my collection of tick items. I wanted to do this video for a while, so I'm super excited to show you all. And a lot of it's older and some of it's newer, but let's check it out. So I'm pulling everything from this giant bag that I got. I'll show you the bag. Maybe further out a little bit. It's a very large bag. It was part of the giveaway from the San Diego Comic-Con. I was not a part of that, but I was able to find it on eBay. And I got everything that came with the kit except for a t-shirt. So the first object that came with that from the San Diego Comic-Con was these tick antlers, or antenna or whatever. He's not a deer, he's a tick. But these are the antenna of the tick. And there's the tick emblem there from the show on Amazon. And then there's the little Prime logo on the other side. So that's the first object. Next we have, pretty similar to it, we have a tick hat with the antenna. Same type of thing. It really looks like they just screwed them in here. See? Watched all the episodes of the Amazon show yet. Watched two of them. I was going to watch them with my kids, but there is some adult language in it, so the pilot didn't have that in it, so we initially watched the first couple, and then as we got into it further, I realized it seems like they're really trying to parody like the Netflix Marvel superhero shows by still making it edgy, but it's, you know, a definite play on what they were doing, I felt. Okay, next object. Let's go with these guys right here. I got a ton of tick stuff. Whenever my son had his tick birthday, we'd been bonding through watching the old Fox Kids show. So I found he wanted to have a tick-themed party. So I was going to get him all the tick toys. So I'll show you. I got doubles, essentially. I got most of a complete set on eBay for him. And then someone else was doing an entire lot of all their tick collection. So that's why I acquired most of this. So I have a lot of doubles. So any toy that he didn't get, I got the double of it. So I just added it to my tick collection. So this one is actually his. This is the Hang Ten Tick. Now he does not talk because I don't have the battery in him. But he says Hang Ten for Justice. And that's from the Tick in Hawaii episode when they meet Pokopo Pete, the pineapple face. But I really like this because, you know, you can definitely tell it's the Hawaiian with the sunglasses on there and the swim trunks. They also have a couple other talking ticks, but we don't own any of those. They have one that has a t-shirt that says, "I love wheat." And then they have a dinosaur meal one. It says, "I dig dinosaurs." You know, the loose items I pull, these are all from my kid's grab bag. So this was another thing. I believe this was a Taco Bell toy. It's like a glider of Arthur. The horrified look on his face there, as usual. And there's LC figurine. And we put these on his cake. little seed wind up. And then he does come off, but it's just his top. Next, there's the Dynamole, I believe was his name. Got a figure of him, too. I don't even really remember much of him. I think he was maybe in one episode of the show. Here's the American Maid. She has judo chop action. And this one is his. And my little girl loves this toy, you know, naturally. There's not many super heroine action figures, so here's a little Tick figurine. Here's the Terror, and this is a bendable. Okay, they make a figure out of him. But we just wanted to add it to the character roster. And he's on the Amazon show too, so. It's the Chameleon. Human Bullet. There's the Sewer Urchin. There's a little Tick on Wheels here. Ooh, that was a little loud, I apologize. Next one, he got broken, unfortunately, this one. See, he's got no bottom. He went to have him sit down, and his butt came off. And then we super glued it like 3 times, and then the other side just gave way. And unfortunately, we weren't able to repair it anymore, but. But I do have one myself still in the box. But as far as the loose ones like this, this one is the only one we have. He's broken, so. I want to keep mine in the box, unless that's a common defect in all of them. Okay, the next one's in the plastic here. These are all from the leftovers that I acquired. A double, so to speak. I forget what they called this guy, but I remember he was the birthday present for Chairface Chippendale. Arthur, and my kid's one actually doesn't have this gross yellowing of the middle region there, but it is common with the older toys for this type of stuff to happen, so. We have the Sewer Urchin, and he has a spraying feature, the water comes out of here. Ah, he's got I thought he had a leg squeeze, but he's got a tab on the back. There's cape flapping there. In another live-action show, his character was Batmanuel, but I'm not exactly sure. I guess there's some sort of copyright issues or something. Any character that was all Fox Kids is somehow a property of, I guess, Disney. Whenever they bought the show to syndicate on Disney XD, I believe. This is Thrakazog, I believe is his name. The alien who always tries to take over. His feature, he has a tongue. I don't know where it went, but there's a tongue that goes in there with another little face on it. And you spin these. And the tongue spins. But I don't know where it is, unfortunately. But this is the character here. Okay. This was the first tick that came out here. Once again, there's that nice yellowing defect that happens. Some say it's from old age, but then I saw that they actually do have some that were printed greenish too for some reason. I'm not sure why, but it was actually in the comics. They had an ad for them that they were trying to play it off. Like, oh, it's a rare green printing variant. So, I'm not sure if this is one of those, or if this is just from yellowing from the sun. And his play feature doesn't really work too well. He's got a spring, because he's always jumping from rooftops. He's supposed to be able to, like, have him hop. Doesn't really work too well, so... I apologize for that loud noise. And this is when the tick gets sick. Thrakazork makes a clone of him with his snot. You put water in here and it comes out the top there. Next we have the chameleon, and he's a harder to find one. I got lucky that I found him. And he color changes if you rub ice cubes on his hands and his feet. It might not even be his feet. I know his hands changed and his eyes too, I believe. They turn like a purplish color. But pretty neat. The dynamo again. To play feature, he blows himself up. So he's standing. See. So, like I said, I only remember him. I think he was in one episode, so I thought it was strange that they made a toy out of him. I guess they just liked how he looked. I feel like this should be the front of him. But it's not. Next we have the human bullet. And then you gotta look and line that up with that. And these old toys that are in. Wish they didn't have the stuff happen with the yellow and things, but they're still pretty cool. And this guy, he doesn't work so well. This is supposed to spin these here. Mouth opens a little bit. This is the brainchild's dog. I believe his name is Max. I can't remember. But he's pretty cool. To figure out what his play feature was. I thought there was some sort of squeeze or like this was supposed to be his play feature here. But then I realized it was the hands. So, oh, that was really silly. It took me so long. I had them for a while. I mean, a long time before I figured it out. So I'm not sure what that says about me, but but it wasn't clear what his play feature was, so. Next we have Dinosaur Neil, and he extends. There's a leg inside of him, a human leg. So, I guess this one's a harder to find one too. That's so weird. You look at these guys, and I don't know if something like this would get made today. You know, having a human body part in it, having it on the shelf. Same goes for the guy who blows himself up. There was a little chair face figurine in there too. I wish they made an action figure of him, but it never happened. But he was a great villain. He changed the moon to have a cha, C-H-A on it. Okay, that bag is empty. This is my son's too. I didn't know that this was an actual thing until I was researching the figures to buy him for his birthday. On the first episode of the cartoon, they put him in this machine to display how powerful he is. And so it's like a death machine. You sit on the side of there. And this is supposed to pop. Sometimes it doesn't. But this is actually where the toy was sitting when it broke. They were trying to sit him in there too hard. There's all these little torture devices here, and they close these on him. Dead. And there's something really bizarre with this toy. Is that there's a little thing in the back. There's a little lever right there to, like, make him squirm. So I thought that was a little weird. Yeah, a squirming feature. But yeah, this is how this guy broke. They were sitting him in here and he wasn't sitting right, and they just, his butt fell off, so. But I thought it was cool, because like I said, I didn't even know that that was a toy. I mean, you guys saw this. This was online. One of my comic haul videos I got recently. A nice little Tick shirt. Apparently the colors don't hold well. I've only worn it maybe four or so times, about once a week or so. And it has, see, you can already see how it's turning red in those bits. The blue looks good because it's a harder plastic, I guess. I don't know. But the blacks are not holding at all well. So red, but it's still a cool shirt. It's got his catchphrase on there. But if you like this, and they also have other shirts and a lot of the stuff I'm showing you, you can find on neckpress.com. That's necpress.com. They are the company that made the Tick, or discovered the Tick, if you want to put it that way. A nice little Happy Meal toy here. It's got the Tick in there. And then it's got all these little Tick quips on the ball. Pretty neat. Next up we got the Tick video game for the Genesis. I got him this for his birthday too. He loves video games, so. But this is a rental copy because the actual game came in just a cardboard box. So. Most games are hard for me, like the old ones like that. And the video game actually follows the first 12 or so issues of the comic pretty closely. It's really about the Tick fighting the ninjas and the clowns. I think the Idea Men are in here too. The Idea Men weren't in the first issues, if I remember. But so here's the plot here. There's Night of a Million Zillion Ninjas. Chairface writes his name on the moon. What Throckazog wants, Throckazog gets. And that's the whole arc, I guess. But it doesn't spell it out here. But I know the first part is like a ton of levels with ninjas. And then there's the Idea Men are in the Chairface stuff. And then we have clowns and aliens in the last arc there. And then they have Oedipus is in the game. She's like a offshoot of Elektra from Daredevil. And then these guys actually help you. Paul the Samurai, who has his loaf of bread he beats people with. Deflatormouse just kind of runs away, if I remember. American Maid helps you. Here's your villains you fight. I wonder if it shows the, yeah, it's got some of them from those first issues. The Red Scare's in here. Chainsaw Vigilante. I don't see Clark, the Cape Wonder, or the Running Man, but I know they're in the game too as mini bosses. But it's a good game, it's just hard. This is my checklist of the comics I'm missing. Show you in a bit. Alright, we got this nice little football. And it's got two images with two phrases on it here. Here, the balancing Tick. I know you guys remember like the little birds they had that could do this, but this was a Taco Bell toy. He's not spinning too well recently, because if you bend the arms, he does get off balance and the toy is pretty much ruined, but he's doing okay right here though. Pretty cool, I really liked this, so. Anyway, this is also from that Tick TV show, Amazon Prime swag bag. Phone cover, but I don't have one of these phones, this is for an iPhone, so. And it's made of like a really soft rubber, I don't know if your phone would even be protected enough. Window Queens. So we have the Chameleon, American Maid, and then, you know, the other guys there. Tick. He has a suction cup there. You can just hang him. But they have these on that website too. The football and party kit stuff like that. is the bags. We never use these because we had too many guests. But the party kit is either $10 or $20, so it's a really good deal if that's something you guys are interested in. Here's the cup from it. These guys here, I don't know if you guys remember Pogs or not. These were a huge craze in the 90s. So. So the hard plastic things were the slammers. So that guy's name is Dean, by the way, with a corkscrew head. There's a ton of different ones. They have, I want to say, like four different or five different characters on the slammer, and then they just do them in different colors. There's a tick. The images kind of repeat themselves here. But what you would do is you would take your stack of them and you want to have them all facing up, like with the printed side up. And a lot of them would be white on the other side, but the gray side would count as white on these. But you would take your, you and your friend would take a slammer and you would try to flip the colored side to the white side. So you take a slammer. Apparently that didn't work so well, but you do that. And so then these ones here would be mine, and then the next player would go and you try to knock down the whole stack, and the game is supposed to be when you knock those, flip those, like, those are supposed to be yours. I believe if you have the most, like, whoever has the most gets to keep whichever ones they knocked out. So I know a lot of people weren't a fan of that because they'd spent, you know, a lot of money collecting the Pogs or whatever. Plus, too, when you slam it, it sometimes puts a dent. I'm not sure if there is one, but yeah, I think I see one right there. But it puts a dent in it. So a lot of people just collect them and not play it. I mean, you'd have people who were poor sports and whatever, and there are other slammers that were like a heavier metal that were considered to some people as cheating. I know a lot of schools banned it, a lot of kids got in fights, and actually, and on my bus, someone hit another kid several times in the head with like a 2-inch thick metal, gold metal slammer, gave him a bloody forehead, so people sometimes did get violent with them, so. And apparently that wasn't unique to my school. I had other friends who told me similar stories. But I have the full set of these Tick Pogs as well. And some of the images still, they kind of repeat as well. But all this stuff was in this set, and I got the set for, I believe, $100 or somewhere around there. I got a really good deal on it, so I was thrilled, you know. We have the sticker book and all the guests to our party, they got one. And the sticker shows like the first, I want to say like the first three episodes of The Tick. If you guys are interested, I might read this or part of it in a later video for you all. In a soft voice like this, maybe. Whatever you guys want, you know. But I got the sticker lot on a separate thing I did get on eBay, though. But like I said, I always try to support my local shops. But for stuff like this, you have to reach out elsewhere, you know. It's just the nature of it. Still in the box with his butt still intact. And this was actually a series 2. It surprises me because this is the better Tick figure. Series 1 had that jumping thing that wasn't so great, you know. With his dog Speak. I don't know if you remember him or not. They can hold a lot of things, like your art prints or whatever. They do tend to wear out, but they are a sturdier material, so it's kind of like a substitute cloth, and then it buttons up top too. Three buttons. And then when they get too heavy, you'll hear those buttons all pop open. And that's when you get concerned and you have to get another bag or something, because it's a good indication that you're damaging the bag. But cool. Next, I want to show you all my, my Tick comics that I have. And I have them. I have some leftover stickers, so I want to peel one, because I know it'll make a good peeling noise. Maybe. I think I just got the paper there, yeah. These stickers you can stick and re-stick. So even as I was flipping through the album, I noticed that they were, I could have peeled them off if I wanted to, so. But let's move on to the comics I have here. Able to get, but I didn't get it in a lot, but every other book I have in my collection I got from the same lot. I think I paid around 50 for this, but it's the first issue, and the first non-special edition print copy of it, so it was worth it, I think. And if you guys are interested to see the contents of it, you can check out Chicho's channel on YouTube here. And this is the first printing of this too. I couldn't believe this was in that same lot with all those other books for $100. But everything else here. I was able to get. Originally the book was black and white. It's an independent title, so that's not uncommon. But the cool thing is with the original books that they were larger print like this. The first 12 were large print. And then they would usually have like some sort of random insert, either a poster or something. Let me see. Case. I don't want to mess with him. I was about to say that looked a lot like the back of number one. But I'll retape these, don't worry about that. Does this one have an insert? This one might have one, I don't know. Yeah, so see? Sometimes you'd get like a little wire in there. And then you'd get like you'd get to see the fan letters and advertisements and other things. The size of the bags are golden age is the size you need. So if you buy the books like I did, I had them hanging out in some makeshift bags. Because oddly some of them weren't in the correct size bags for, you know, the reason of just not being a common bag type. Everything else is first printing. And yeah, I see then this one had a poster with it. Famous Tick Nightmare Sequence. Unfortunately. And then yeah, some of the later ones are thicker. But the reason for that is they have like things where they're selling merchandise in them. This one might not be. There's some of it there. But you would look, and then suddenly there would be ads for tick merch. So, kind of cool. If you're into that, which I am, so. The one had like a full color ad thing in it. I was really blown away with. I can't remember which one though. A little over 100 issues. There's the site. Well, that says NEC Comics. But I know it's NECPress.com. I don't think this is a color series yet. Let me check. Not color yet. The later ones can be fine to switch to color, but I know I see you interested in self-publishing. I'll see you as soon as I look in that one, the next issue. These are when they start to be in color. So, well, granted, they did a reprint. Now, see, there's some of your. That's just showing off all the issues there. But even at that point, like, that color is a different type of color than your typical comic book. Reprinted the first 9 issues. It's either the first 9 or the first 6, I can't remember. And the name of that series is Chromatic. Are like, it's like an encyclopedia that shows all the characters from A to Z and the Tick universe. So if you're curious about the characters, that's what that is. And then I have the free comic book day Tick books too. And these, you can actually contact them. How I got them is you can send them a self-addressed envelope and request which copies you want with the postage, I believe. See, there's the website right there. But, is it this one? Yeah, there it is. It tells you the cost of the postage, so you just put the postage in an envelope mailed to them inside an envelope and tell them which issues you want, and they'll mail it out to you, which is how I got them all. So, and I got all the back issues for it except for the first one, which is just a reprint of the first issues, so like $2 a piece, so, or maybe they're $4, I don't remember, but they're not a lot if you don't want to go through all the weird self-addressed stuff. And then this is the first issue of the new series that they've just started. But that's it. Like I said, I've got about half of the books, and I look forward to getting the rest. And if you don't know who the Tick is, I highly recommend him. go to neckpress.com or find some of those old episodes or watch the new show. And hope you enjoy the character and you have a good day and a good night, whether you're watching this either time. Thanks so much, guys. Bye.